So there's lots of videos out there on the internet how to use a piece of threaded rod, put it through your clutch, and to take your helix apart, take your snap ring out so it doesn't go flying and bonk you in the head. We're not going to go through that on this this particular one. It wasn't a lot of pressure. It really wasn't, really didn't need to use it. We weren't sure if we're going or if we needed to or not, but we didn't. You can see here there's lots of, you know, it's real easy. One of the reasons, so the reason we took this out was to get more load on this. And if we look here, there's a stamping in here that marks factory setting on there. And so factory setting is at hole three. They're labeled 1 to 4. We're going to move it to hole 4, and it's going to allow us to get a little more rev on the engine.
Carl, see if you can figure out what's wrong with this thing. It won't crank up and everything seemed to be put together right.
Bill, I see you.
Okay,
stop back by.
Don't worry about your boy now. He's, you're doing good.
It ain't got no gas in it.
Yeah. Everything was riding good. The upgrade seemed to be working well. And then this happened.
Pulling in for number two. Both of them quit within 100 feet of each other. Not sure what happened. The only thing we can think of was bad gas.
So we did some further investigation after we got back, and it turns out that the red one quit running because it had plugged air filters, so it just wasn't getting enough air into the engine. And the blue one quit because it doesn't, you know, quit getting spark and it wouldn't run anymore. So funny how they were both, you know, two completely separate issues just happened to stop in the same place. So we're gonna have to get some better ride footage at a later date. But with that said, be sure to drop a like, subscribe if you aren't already, and thanks for watching.